Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about basic concepts in SAS programming. SAS program contains two steps. First one is data step that is used for creation and manipulation of data, and it always starts with a keyword data. And second one is a procedure step, also known as a proc step, used for analysis and reporting, and it always start with proc keyword. So here is an example of a data step program, and this one is an example of proc step program. So you can see the basic characteristic of SAS program. It always begins with a SAS keyword, either data or a proc, depending upon what type of program is that. And it always ends with a semicolon. So you can see it's always ends with a semicolon. So giving more details, here I'm again showing you the data step program and proc step program. So each line is actually one statement. So first statement is a data statement. The second one is a set statement, and third one is a run statement. And each statement ends with a semicolon. So that is very important point we have to remember. So data steps program start with a keyword data, and each statement ends with a semicolon. The likewise proc statements also start with a proc keyword, and each statement ends with a semicolon. So here is the three statements in this program, and there are two statements in this program. So moving further, I'm going to explain you about the SAS libraries and SAS data files. So this is a screenshot from SAS Studio, like how the SAS libraries and SAS data sets basically looks like. So I'm here actually red, mark here. You can see that is actually representing the SAS data libraries. So these libraries are already in the SAS program. And here, each libraries, have that much of the SAS data files. So multiple files can be, present in each library. So how you can refer these SAS files and these libraries in your program? So basically two level names is used. First, you have to define your library name, that is libreference here, libref, and after that your data files, SAS data files, so that is the file name, and you have to use a period in between. So this is how you will refer any library and their data set, a specific data set. So for example, in this program, you can say this is a data step program. So the first line is the data statements. So here I'm going to generate a new SAS data file named new class and going to store in work library. So I have to define first library name, period, and then after that, the SAS data file name. And this is a set statement. So SAS statement is basically to retrieve the existing library and existing files that is already present. So the first one in the red mark is showing the name of the library, and after a period, the name of the data set that is going to retrieve. And this one is the run statement that is actually a sign of the completion of the program. So this is how the SAS library and SAS data files basically reference while programming. So just for more details, I can tell you there are two different kind of libraries. One is permanent libraries, which are actually present already in the SAS program, and temporary library, mainly the work library, where you don't really need to define. For example, here I'm defining work library to generate this data set here, in work library. But if you are not giving reference of the library, it will automatically go to the work library. So this is very simple how you can, reference a SAS files in SAS program. Moving further, this is an overview of data set. So data set in SAS program has two portion. One is a descriptor portion, which is marked here with a red line. And the second one is a data portion. Data portion is marked with dotted line here. And this data portion has two different type of, two different kinds of stuff there. One is the observation, which is basically representing the row. So this is like third observation and fourth observation marked here in the blue color. And the second type of, informations that is present in data portion is variable, which are also known as columns. So there are different columns here. Green one is marked as a sex and the other one is the age. So these are the columns actually. So you can see more details here. So descriptor portions where the data set attributes are actually there. So each variables here associated with certain attributes about the name, what kind of data is there, if there are any informat associated with that variable or not. So those kind of information is always associated with these variables in descriptor portion. So I will tell you more about the descriptor portions in my next slide. So this is a variable attributes, as I told you. So if you click in any variable name here, you will see this information that is marked in red color here. So I clicked in height and you will see it will tell you details about the, what attributes are associated with height variable. So that level is associated like height, which is same as a name. Name is also height, length is 8, and type of this variable is numeric. And there is no format or informat is associated with this variable. So this is basically a variable attributes, which is associated with specific variable. So this is very important to understand. And in my next slide, I will explain you about how you can understand these attributes and what are their characteristic, and if there is a way that you can change, and what are actually rules for giving these attributes. So this is a screenshot of certain attributes of a data set. So these attributes, as I told you, so the name, type, length, format, informat, and labels. So these are the attributes associated with any kind of variables. So there are three variables here. One is policy, second one is total, and third one is name. So the name of these variables is is the name of the variables. These are the type of the variables, like policy is a numeric variable, has a length of 8, and associated label is a policy number. So I will give you one, details information one by one. So first I will go for the name attributes. So name attributes is like how you can define the name of a variable. So this is very important to understand. The name of a variable must be 1 to 32 character long. It cannot be more than that. And it always begin with a letter, either uppercase or lowercase or underscore. And number cannot be used, in the beginning, but number can be used in the middle or at the end. So for example, these three are, acceptable name of a variable, but here these are the not acceptable name of any variables because it start with, numbers, and here in a special character is actually present. So this is how the name of a variable should be in SAS program. The second one is a type. There are two type of variables, present in the SAS program. So this is the second attribute. So type should be either character variable or numeric variables. So character variable can be any value, either letter or number or a special character, whereas a numeric variable can only be numeric value, and it can be a digit ranging from 0 to 9, and can have like plus or minus sign or a decimal, and it also accept the scientific notion. So the third attribute of a variable is length. So character variable length can go up to maximum 32,767 bytes long. And for example, here name variable has a length actually of 20. That means it is using 20 bytes of storage. And the numeric variable by default length is 8. And no matter how many digits are stored as a floating point numbers, but you know, by default length will be 8. And if you want to change, you can do that. You know, so this is the third attributes of a variable. And fourth attributes of the variable is format. Formats basically write values out by using some particular form. So this is used in writing of a data set, in output data set. So suppose if you have a number 1, 2, 3, and you want to write this number with a dollar sign and comma and, you know, after period 2, 0, so you have to use $8.2 format that will change this number to this format. And the fifth attribute is informat attribute. Informat attribute basically read data. So format write a data and informat read a data value in a certain formats into a standard SAS value. So this is input of a data value. So suppose if you have a number like this and you want to change in a normal format, you have to use this informat to read this number like 1, 2, 3. And the last one is a label attribute. So label basically whatever the text that is descriptive text associated with a particular variable, and up to 256 characters long, you know, labels can be accepted in SAS program. So I gave you an idea about each attributes of a variable: name, type, length, format, informat, and label. So these information are very critical, and we have to keep in mind while we are using SAS programming. So the next, I am going to explain you the missing value in SAS program. So missing value, if you have a character variable and the character variable is missing, it's represented by a blank. And if a numeric variable is missing, it's represents by a dot actually. So you can see the name is missing, so it's a blank. And if age is missing, age is a numeric variable, so it's represented by a period or a dot here. And this is also important. So the last thing I'm going to tell you about the different kind of data sets. The first one is the in-stream data. Like here we are doing data entry through the SAS program, and each value is entering within the SAS program. And existing data, for retrieving any existing file, we have to use set statement. You have to use give the reference of the library and the SAS dataset file name, and then you have to retrieve, and this file will generate it, you know. So this program is for the existing dataset. And the third one is the XStream data. If you have any data file that is saved in any outside format, so you have to bring that file within SAS program. So this is these are the some SAS program where different kind of data can be used and processed in SAS program. So this is all the introductory you know, information about the SAS data sets, their attributes, what are the, you know, variables, and what are the basically observations. So these informations will be used throughout the programming. Thank you very much for watching.